Let me talk to you. Last Friday on SmackDown, Bray Wyatt brought back the Firefly Funhouse. Yippee! A grown man incel playing with puppets with spooky music, and I'm supposed to be scared of that. Huh? Wrong! If I was any more a man, there'd be two of me standing here right now. Meanwhile, this guy is living on past glory, and it just got me thinking. Here we are, Raw is turning 30 years old tonight. There's a bunch of legends back there running around. They're living on past glory. Bray Wyatt's living on past glory. And it just has me thinking. If any single one of those legends right now has enough tingle in their loins, yeah! Why don't you come on down here, and I'll give you a little preview of the Pitch Black match at Royal Rumble at your expense. Yeah! That's about what I thought. I didn't think anybody'd show up, because they ain't got enough to fit.
Of The Undertaker.
Big Evil is in the house.
Before we take this anywhere, I heard what you said on Joe Rogan about the locker room being soft. Hey, I agree with you. You look back there, there's a bunch of softies back there. Top of the list is Bray Wyatt. But I'm gonna tell you like this, if you think I fall under that umbrella, somebody told you the wrong story. But I tell you what, you're giving me an opportunity to do something right now. Let's just think about something here. Think of the irony of the headline that we can create right now. LA Knight sends The Undertaker to The Undertaker. Yeah! So I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you a pass. I'm going to let you live to see another day. I'm going to let you live to enjoy retirement. Enjoy your family. Oh, but I want you to watch the Pitch Black match at Royal Rumble, because after that, they're going to be calling me the Lord of Darkness. Yeah! Oh, one more thing. Taker, if anybody ever asks you whose game it is and you're confused, just listen, because you'll hear everybody saying, L.A. Knight. Yeah!
Anniversary of Monday Night Raw. What a moment as Bray Wyatt